Hi there. Today is Saturday, April 5th, and I have my crazy dog here. And there was interest in learning how I got my dog to do all that fancy sidestepping in the behind position. So I want to break it down into a couple of different steps, probably about five steps or so. So number one, you need to have a dog that knows how to sidestep. And so in order to have your dog know how to sidestep, they first need to know how to pivot. So we'll probably do this in a couple of different video clips, but we'll start with the pivoting. So this is a round mark bucket. This is also, you could use a phone book also, or a little square box or something of that nature for your dog to put their front feet on and learn how to pivot around. I can break this down further if there's somebody that wants me to do that, but this is kind of a quick review. So let me show you what this looks like. So I put it down and my dog loves to put her feet on the mark. So that was like a silly click when you put that away. So when my dog is doing that good, then I want my dog to start moving around the mark bucket. That's all really good. So of course she's all trained up, so this is easy for her. So move around the mark bucket. So I'm teaching her to move her butt so that she has, her brain is connected to how she would use her butt. So we've done a bunch of that, and then we can also teach her to go from here to get into heel position like that. Okay. So we can then have my dog go around the mark bucket. Because I'm teaching her that it's valuable to be in heel position. And then she can swing her butt into heel position. And you, for freestyle, we want to train this on both sides. Yes, that's true. So, yes, good girl. So, yes. Good job. Tight. Good job. Whoops. Good job. Excellent. Okay. Training that goes into building that up. You don't just like do it that fast, but this is just a review for her. So now I have my doggy. So if my dog has gotten really comfortable doing it on the mark bucket like that, then I can start having my dog go like that. So she's doing it without the mark bucket. Good job. And I'm really marking for her butt moving. And it's nice to have, I have my iPad facing me so that I can see in the mirror what we look like. Super. Because it's all about getting that butt to move. Now that I got the butt moving pretty well, then I'm gonna add the front. Front legs move a lot easier than the back legs. So we'll tell her side. That's it. So I really want to pay attention to making sure that my dog's butt moves with the front legs and doesn't trail behind. And it takes practice, okay? They don't just automatically get that. Good girl. That's super. So when I have that going really good on the sides, I can also work on the front. So front. Now it's really important to have your dog have a straight front. So this is actually really pretty straight here. It seems a little crooked, but maybe it's because I'm crooked. So now that I have my dog in a front position, I want to build value for that front position. And in freestyle, she does both freestyle and she does rally obedience. So she moved into an SIT, which I don't like that much. So anyway, she's busy listening to my every word, and then I will have her stand and we'll get to work. So in your front position, you also want to have your dog be able to move sideways. And you really want to, you know, all this is just little stuff that I work on a little bit every day, probably. Stand. Good. So my word is front. So if I move and I ask my dog to front, my dog should stay in front. I know, I'm ready. Front. Good. Front. notice where I put the cookie? I put the cookie right in front of the dog. Oops. She tends to go too far, especially to the right. Good girl. Good girl. Uh-oh, distraction. I dropped a cookie. Front. Good straight. That's it. Good. Front. Oh, it's harder with the ball of cookie. There you go. Good job. Good girl. That was super. All right. I'll take a quick break on that, and then we'll work on the other piece.